All right, besides losing weight, it is probably one of the most popular New Year's resolutions. That is getting a handle on your money. It's not too late, our guest. He has advice on how to figure out how to view your money and your finances so you can actually make some better decisions. Joe Duran is a chartered financial analyst, and he's author of The Money Code, Improve Your Entire Financial Life Right Now. Wow, that's a big order. That's a tall order.
It's a tall order.
But it's fascinating. I love the book, and I love the idea of how you break down how you spend money based on your own emotions and your own feelings. Yeah. Tell us about that. There are three elements.
Well, there's three elements. People are either driven by fear, an urge to protect and finding peace of mind, an urge to enjoy life or happiness, or a desire to help other people, commitment. And really, because money only does three things. It helps you to enjoy life, it helps you to take care of the things you're afraid of, and it helps you to take care of the people you love. And when money is involved, which is very emotional, you tend to revert to your primary core value. And so for me, I grew up in Zimbabwe in a very, very stressful environment, and so my primary driver is fear. My urge is to protect. When I make decisions, my first thought is, how do I protect myself? And that is the overwhelmingly largest segment of society, by the way, is driven by fear.
Driven by fear.
The next is happiness, and the next is commitment. But the reason we wrote this book is because people do not think about their emotions, and when they make the same mistakes over and over again, it's because their emotions are making the decision when it comes to money.
I want our viewers to go to this website here. So this is how you, the quiz to determine your money mind. It is mymoneycode.com here.
So the easiest is to go to Honest Conversations. It's really easy to remember.
It's fascinating.
So our Honest team, Conversations with an S.
Yeah. Okay, and Honest Conversations. So our team took it. Yeah. Most of our team, they spend money and they save money, and the motivation is fear. Just like you said, I took the quiz as well, and the results were 43% fear, 43% happiness. Yeah. That's how I determine how I spend or how I save.
So you have a very balanced approach. What it says is that you're very, it's very unusual, by the way, because what you'll find is overwhelmingly 85% of people have a very dominant money mind. It's very unusual for people to have both perspectives, because what typically happens, as the case for most of your folks, if you're driven by fear, you typically delay gratification. You don't take trips, you don't vacation, you don't buy the things that you want to buy because you want to find safety. And so you're very good at saving money and often a very bad investor, unfortunately, because what happens is you only want to buy when it feels safe, which it only feels safe after the market has gone up. And so one of the things we see, since we are taking care of our clients' entire financial well-being, is to help them understand that their natural biases are going to affect them and help them to make the same mistakes over and over. And we try to hold up a mirror and say, hey, listen, we've got to change course here. So you have a very balanced approach. Good for you. It'll make it very easy for you to see both sides. But for a lot of your team, what they're going to need to do is to be told, hey, listen, it's okay to enjoy life. Because what happens for many fear money minds is they defer enjoyment and gratification to try to find peace of mind that they never really find, by the way. Folks with lots of money who are driven by fear still feel this need to find security, even when they have more money than you and I could spend.
So it's okay to spend a little. It's okay to splurge every once in a while.
Yeah.
To allow the happiness to determine
and
how.
I think for all of us, the important thing when you're with, it's not just for yourself, when you're in a committed relationship, how do you talk about money with other people as well?
All right. Joe, thank you so much.
Thank
you. Love the book, and we're going to have a lot of folks, you know, weigh in and take that quiz. Thanks again.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.